Well, good morning to you. It is 8 a.m. It's been a very ugly day on the roadways. We are following breaking news along I-5 right now, a deadly accident in South Sacramento County.
And this is happening near Hood Franklin Road, south of Elk Grove. A car hit a big rig head on, and now the rig is on its side, and it's blocking the northbound lanes. KCR3's Brian Hickey joining us now live with how this all happened.
Yeah, and take a look behind me. You can see the big rig as it tried to avoid this collision on the northbound side of I-5 right at the Elk Grove Boulevard 1 mile sign. CHP telling us that a white BMW was heading southbound on I-5 at a high rate of speed, according to witness statements, when for whatever reason that BMW crossed over the center divide and went head on with this Safeway big rig here on the northbound lanes. The driver of the big rig obviously swerved off the road, and you can see where he ended up on his side here at Elk Grove Boulevard. He was taken to the hospital with what are being described as minor scrapes and bruises that would come from a crash like this, but otherwise in good condition, according to a Safeway spokesperson out here this morning. Look at this video now. You can see the car just obliterated in this collision. And CHP saying that is an obvious indication of the speed that was involved here, even after that car had gone across the center divide. The engine plucked from the vehicle. The wheels, the hood, the whole front end completely detached from the front of that car, leaving the driver's compartment completely intact, where the driver was killed instantly in this collision. We understand he's a 25-year-old out of Antioch that causes collision. Again, the driver of the big rig, okay, but just a terrible scene out here. And I, again, you can see what's going on here. At this point, the big rig is going to need to be offloaded. It's a Safeway truck fully loaded with produce. They're going to have to come out and offload that truck before it can be removed from the scene. And that means this slow lane is going to be blocked until they get that process finished, unless the big rig tows can pull him onto the shoulder where that job can take place. But for right now, northbound 5 still down to one lane. That's the latest here. I'm Brian Hickey, KCRA3 reports.
This is Dan Shively in Live Copter 3 with a different view of the truck. You can see that workers are down there. The top of the truck now has become the side of the truck, and it's just hanging there. It doesn't even appear to be attached to the rest of the truck. And as Brian said, the big rig tow trucks cannot put that trailer upright because everything would fall out. So they're going to have to wait until the other truck shows up from Safeway to offload it before they can start dealing with it. But just look at how flimsy that roof is. They've got one or two workers down there that are actually lifting it up, and you can see some of the spilled load underneath it there. But that's only part of the problem. As we widen out and take a look at the backup, that is the big problem right now. Only one lane of traffic is open, the fast lane, and the backup is back past Twin Cities Road. So it is going to be just almost a parking lot all the way up to pretty much this accident scene. So that's the situation here. As we keep panning up into the haze, you can see just how heavy that traffic is. Look at the other side, though. Southbound I-5 moving along nicely, not even slowing down a bit.